Hi, I'm Todd from Sony, and I'm here to show you how to download and transfer a firmware update to your Sony Blu-ray Disc Player that does not have internet capability. Once you've determined that you need a firmware update, there are three important steps that must be followed in order to complete the firmware update. Download the update from the esupport.sony.com website, create an update disc, and update the player. This whole process could take up to 45 minutes to complete. By the way, if you need information on how to verify your current firmware version, please visit esupport.sony.com or our Sony Listens YouTube channel for steps on this process. As a part of the update process, you will need to burn a disk. Make sure you are using a personal computer that has the capability to burn CDs. Just so you know, if you are unable to create your own disk, you can order one from Sony for a nominal charge, and we will mail it directly to you. So, let's get started. Be sure to have a new blank CDR disk handy for recording. Check here for the industry standard CDR logo. And please note that CDRW disks are not recommended. The disks are sold separately. For my demonstration, I'm using the BDP-S300 Sony Blu-ray Disc Player. Products can be slightly different, so be sure to check the owner's manual or visit us at esupport.sony.com for your specific features and menu options. The first thing we need to do is download the update. Using a personal computer, go to esupport.sony.com. Enter in your Blu-ray Disc Player model number. Select the Driver and Software tab. Select the operating system of your computer. Then select Firmware, followed by Download. And the firmware update page opens. Please note that all the information and instructions regarding a firmware update can be found here. You should take a few moments to review this information. Remember, as a part of the update process, you will need to burn the firmware update to a brand new blank CDR disk. Do not use a CDRW disk. So, let's go ahead and download the update by clicking the Download Now link, which is located at both the top and the bottom of the page. Once you have reviewed the software agreement, click on Accept Agreement. The file download box appears. Click on Save. I'm going to save to my desktop. You can choose to save this file in a different location, but please make a note of where you saved the file. You'll need this information later. Once you've selected where you would like to save the file, click Save again. It is very important that we verify that the size of the downloaded file is correct before proceeding. The size of the update will always be listed on the eSupport website for comparison. It's important that both match so you are not missing any files. Locate the directory where the file was saved. Then right-click the file to display the drop-down listing of commands, selecting Properties. Once the property screen displays, check the size and verify that the number listed is the same as the size listed on the download page for the update. Note that we're looking for the size and not the size on disk number, which can be different. If the file size is different, then download the update again. Once you have validated that the file size is correct, double-click on the downloaded file to begin the extraction process. A dialog box appears. Select a location to store the extracted file to, and then click OK. I'm going to extract this file to my desktop. The extracted file will have the .iso format, which is an executable file. Make sure you're burning a disk image and not a data CD, such as an MP3 or MP4 file. We can now create the firmware update disk. Insert a blank CDR disk into the computer. Right-click on the extracted file. Select Open With. Now, I'm going to use Windows Disk Image Burner, but feel free to use any CD burning software that you're comfortable with. If there are multiple CDR drives on your system, select the proper drive. Check the Verify Disk After Burning box, and then click Burn. Once the firmware update disk has been created, now it's time to move to the final step, which is updating the Blu-ray disc player. The update will take approximately 30 minutes, and it's important that you do not turn the unit off or press any buttons during the update process. Power on the Blu-ray player, insert the disc, and then close the tray. The update should start immediately and cycle on and off while the appropriate levels of progress display. The firmware update is complete when the OK message is displayed. The unit will shut down with the disk tray open, and at that time, you can remove the disk and then power on the unit. After the tray closes and the unit resets, check the firmware update version to be sure you have completed the process successfully. For more tips, tricks, and how-to videos, please visit us at esupport.sony.com or on our Sony Listens YouTube channel. Thank you.